Hello students, welcome to maths class. We are dealing with second derivatives. Today we will finish these second derivatives. What is meant by second derivatives means we will differentiate the given function two times. First time first derivative, second time second derivative, right? So in this chapter, first some two types of questions they can ask. In one question, directly find the second derivative they will ask. In another questions, they will give show that some equation will be given to you. In that equation, you will have y double dash, right? So y double dash means, y dash means first derivative of y. Y double dash means second derivative of y. Okay, so whenever it is second derivative is asked, just solve first time differentiate it, again differentiate it, you will get your second derivative value. Okay, so today we will finish these second derivative problems from the exercise 9D. Okay, so come on, come to the first question. Find second order derivative of y is equal to log of 4x square minus 9. Okay, so come on, given function is y is equal to log of 4x square minus 9. Okay, we have to differentiate this one. So here log of some complex form is there, we will make it simple, right? So how we can write y is equal to log of, come on, it is 2x whole square minus 3 square. Okay, so is equal to log of, come on, it is a square minus b square form, a plus b into a minus b. So it is 2x plus 3 into 2x minus 3. Okay, so which form? Log m into n form, log m plus log n. So log 2x plus 3 plus log of 2x minus 3, right? There is a formula. What is that formula? Log of m into n is equal to log m plus log n. In logarithms we are having one formula, log m into n is equal to log m plus log n. Okay, so this one log m into n form, so we can write log m plus log n. This is the y value, right? So now find out first derivative. First derivative means y dash. Y dash means, come on, it is d by dx of y. So is equal to d by dx of, what is the y? This is the y. See, after the simplification, we got some simple value so that we can easily differentiate it. Okay, so this is nothing but how we can take d by dx of log of 2x plus 3 plus log of 2x minus 3. Okay, so whenever in derivatives plus sign is there, we have to take a separate derivatives, right? So we can write this as d by dx of log of 2x plus 3 plus d by dx of log of 2x minus 3. Okay, so is equal to d by dx of log of any value is 1 by 2x plus 3, isn't it? D by dx of x, right? D by dx of log x is equal to 1 by of that variable into d by dx of that variable. So we have to take here into d by dx of 2x plus 3. Similarly, here we have to take 1 by 2x minus 3 into d by dx of 2x minus 3. Okay, so is equal to d by dx of 2x plus 3, right? Whenever plus is there, we have to take a separate derivatives, plus minus, right? We will start from here, 1 by 2x plus 3 right, into, come on, it is d by dx of 2x plus d by dx of 3, okay, plus 1 by 2x minus 3 into d by dx of 2x minus d by dx of minus 3, okay. So this is your y dash. Y dash is equal to 1 by 2x plus 3. Come on, this is d by dx of 2x. 2 is a constant, right? So it is d by 2 can be taken outside. 2 into d by dx of x. D by dx of x is 1. 2 into 1 is 2, right? So 2 plus d by dx of a constant. Right. So, it is d by dx of constant is 0. Numbers and letters are said to be constants. Right. So, 0. Okay. Plus 1 by, what is this? It is 2x minus 3. Okay. So, is equal to d by dx of 2x, 2 minus d by dx of 3, that is 0. Right. So, what is the value now? It is 2 by 2x plus 3 plus 2 by 2x minus 3. This is your y dash. So, we can write this y dash as 2 into 2x plus 3 to the power of minus 1 plus 2 into 2x minus 3 to the power of minus 1. Okay, so this is the y dash. Now you take y double dash. Question is find the second derivative of first derivative y dash, second derivative y double dash, right? So it is d by dx of y dash. So it is d by dx of y dash. It is 2 into 2x plus 3 to the power of minus 1 plus 2 into 2x minus 3 to the power of minus 1. So is equal to, whenever plus is there, we have to take separate derivatives. So d by dx of 2 into 2x plus 3 to the power of minus 1 plus d by dx of 2 into 2x minus 3 to the power of minus 1. So is equal to 2 outside, d by dx of x to the power of n form, right? 2 is a constant into d by dx of this one. Any value is having power n, right? Then we will take that as d by dx of x to the power of n. What is that formula? N into x to the power of n minus 1 into d by dx of that variable. Instead of x, we are having this one. So, n means minus 1, right? Variable place, we are having 2x plus 3 to the power of n minus 1 into d by dx of that variable 2x plus 3. Okay? Similarly, here 2 into d by dx of this variable to the power of n. So, it is minus 1, right? 2x minus 3 to the power of n minus 1 into d by dx of 2x minus 3. Okay, so is equal to, come on, minus 2, 2x plus 3 to the power of minus 2. D by dx of 2x is 2, d by dx of 3 is 0, so into 2. Here also minus 2, right? 2x minus 3 to the power of minus 2 into 2. Okay, so come on, 2 2's are 4. Here also 2 2's are 4. So it is minus 4 into 2x plus 3 to the power of minus 2 minus 4, 2 2's are, right? Into 2x minus 3 to the power of minus 2. So you take minus 4 outside, right, and write down this as 1 by 2x plus 3 whole square, minus is taken outside, right, plus 1 by 2x minus 3 whole square. Okay, so now is equal to minus 4. Taking the LCM, how we can take the LCM? It is 2x plus 3 whole square, 2x minus 3 whole square. So it is 2x minus 3 whole square plus 2x plus 3 whole square. Right? So come on, how we can take minus 4 in a product? If both are having same power, we can take that power as combinedly. Right? So we can take 2x plus 3 into 2x minus 3 whole to the power of, right, square. This is a minus b whole square form. This one a plus b whole square form. So expand it. It is 4x square plus 9, right, minus 2 2 is a 4, 4 3 is a 12x, right. Next, 4x square plus 9, right, a square plus b square plus 2ab plus 12x. Okay, so plus 12x minus 12x cancels. So is equal to minus 4 into, come on, 4x square plus 4x square, 8x square, right, 9 plus 9, it is 18, by a plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square, a square 2x whole square, that is 4x square, minus b square 3 square, that is 9 whole square. Okay, so from these 8x square plus 18, we can take 2 common, isn't it? This 2 4s are 2 9s are, and take the 2 outside. So then you will have minus 8, right, 4x square plus 9 by, come on, it is 4x square minus 9 whole square. Okay, that is the answer. So here little bit lengthy, but simplification is there. Okay, so whenever it is like that, 1 by of something, we have to take the LCM and we have to simplify. Okay, so most repeated question, right, 4 marks question. If y is equal to log of this one, then find the second derivative of this one, right. Second derivative means 2 times we have to differentiate. First of all, it is log of some complex form. So make it simple, right. Make that value as a simple value. How we can make that value as simple? So by taking log of a square minus b square form, right? So 4x square can be written as 2x whole square, 9 can be written as 3 square, right? It is of the form a square minus b square form. So a plus b into a minus b. Then it is of the form log m into n form, that is log m plus log n, log of m into n, right, log of m into n is equal to log m plus log n. So log of m into n form, log m plus log n. So we can take our y dash, right, then we can take y double dash also. Okay, so that is your answer. Now come to the second question. What is your second question? Find the second derivative of, right? So y is equal to, it is tan inverse of, come on, 3x minus x cube by 1 minus 3x square. Okay, so already in a differentiation, we did some problems. Whenever inverse is there, and only tan inverse x we can easily differentiate it. D by dx of tan inverse x is 1 by 1 plus x square, but here it is a tan inverse of some complex form. So I said if the given problem is inverse and inside some complex form is there, go for substitution. First you substitute in place of x, you substitute something and convert that problem into simple form, then you differentiate it. Okay, so here we will take, put x is equal to tan theta, we will take, right? Then what happens? Y is equal to tan inverse of, come on, 3 tan theta, you can take capital or small, both are equal, is equal to tan cube theta by 1 minus 3 tan square theta. It is standard form. What is that? Tan 3 theta formula by trigonometry, that value is equal to tan 3 theta. So it is tan inverse of tan 3 theta. Okay, so tan inverse, tan cancel. So it is y is equal to 3 theta. Okay, so is equal to 3 into, what is theta? Send tan this side, right? So from this, you send tan this side, what happens? It is tan inverse x is equal to theta. So in this theta place, you take that value, what is that? It is tan inverse x. See, first in the beginning, they have given y is equal to tan inverse of 3x minus x cube by 1 minus 3x square, but now we got y is equal to 3 tan inverse x. So this is called substitutional differentiation. In differentiation, three methods I said, right? Differentiation by substitution, right? Logarithmic differentiation, substitution differentiation, and parametric differentiation. I said if two equations are given to you, then you have to go for parametric differentiation. So here we have taken substitution method. Okay, so now your y is very simple. You find out your first derivative. What is your first derivative? It is d by dx of y. So it is d by dx of 3 tan inverse x, right? So is equal to 3 into d by dx of tan inverse x. Okay, so is equal to 3 into 1 by 1 plus x square. This is your y dash. That means first derivative, but we have to find second derivative, right? So come on, find out the second derivative is equal to d by dx of y dash. So it is d by dx of, come on, 3 into, we can write this as 1 plus x square to the power of minus 1, isn't it? So 1 by 1 plus x square can be written as 1 by 1 plus x square to the power of 1. Okay, so if we want to write this in this form, upwards 1 plus x square to the power of minus 1. Why we are writing? We are having in derivative only formula as d by dx of x to the power of n. That n is power. That power can be positive or negative. So we can write any value which is not in that form into this form. Okay, so come on, is equal to, we will write 3 into d by dx of 1 plus x square to the power of minus 1. 3 into any variable to the power of n is n into that variable to the power of n minus 1 into d by dx of that variable. So here we can write minus 1 into 1 plus x square to the power of n minus 1 into d by dx of 1 plus x square. Okay, so is equal to 3 into minus 1 is minus 3 into 1 plus x square to the power of minus 2. Come on, this one is d by dx of 1 is 0 plus d by dx of x square is 2x, right? So is equal to minus, right? 3 into 2 is minus 6x into 1 plus x square to the power of minus 2. We can write this as minus 6x by 1 plus x square whole square. That is the answer of your question. Okay, so in this second question, right, so already while dealing the derivative problems, differentiation, we discussed in the dealing with the first derivative, that means one time differentiation we are doing there, right? So in there we discussed that whenever the given function is inverse and again inverse of the value is complex form, right? First, by using substitution method, make that complex form into simple form. So here we did y is equal to tan inverse of 3x minus x cube by 1 minus x square. Put x is equal to tan theta so that your complex form will be in simple form. Tan inverse tan get cancelled, 3 theta. Again theta is nothing but 3 tan inverse x. Okay, so then you find out your y dash. Y dash is d by dx of y. Right, so we got 3 tan inverse x as our y, and differentiate, you will get first derivative, again you differentiate, you will get your second derivative. Okay, so this is your second question. So whenever we are having one by variable is having power, try to write that as x to the power of n form, where n is power, it can be positive or negative. We are having only formula in differentiation, power is there, that is d by dx of x to the power of n. Okay, so suppose we are having 1 by some variable, power is there, then bring that 2 upwards so that it will be in the form of x to the power of n, and we can apply the formula as d by dx of x to the power of n. Okay, so that is your, here we did like that, we have taken this as power is 1 and we have taken that power upwards, so it will be in the form of d by dx of x to the power of n. In x means it is a formula, I said in all the formulas x, theta, these represents the general forms. Instead of that x, instead of that theta, we can have any other value, right? So formulas means general form. Instead of that value, we will have any other value. Instead of x variable, here we are having 1 plus x square, right? So it is x to the power of n form. Instead of variable, we are having 1 plus x square, right? Instead of x, the variable here is 1 plus x square. So formula is n into d by dx of variable to the power of n minus 1. So your n is minus 1, right? N into variable to the power of n minus 1 into d by dx of variable will be there, right? D by dx of the variable, d by dx of 1 plus x square means, again whenever in the derivative plus sign is there, minus sign is there, we have to take the separate derivatives. So it is nothing but d by dx of 1 numbers and letters are constants, derivative of constants is 0, and d by dx of x square is 2x, right? So then 2 3s are 6. So minus 6x into 1 plus x square to the power of minus 2. We can write that as like that. That is your answer. So with this, we finished our second derivative problems. Okay, so very simple second derivative problems means in sometimes directly they will ask find the second derivative of the following equation. Sometimes they will give one function to you and show that y double dash plus 4y is equal to 3x, or y double dash plus y cos x is equal to 6. Like that some equation will be given, but in that equation you will get y double dash. So y double dash is there means it is nothing but we have to go for second derivative of y. First derivative is denoted by y dash. Second derivative is denoted by y double dash. So in the question, in show that, prove that problems, y double dash is there means we have to go for second derivative. Okay, so these are the problems, most repeated problems from the second derivatives from the exercise 9D, right? We completed the second derivative problems. So in the first problem, just log of 4x square minus 9 is given to you. Log of, inside the log some form is a little bit complex form. So make it simple. How we will make it simple? This can be written as a square minus b square form. So 4x square can be written as 2x whole square, right? 2x square, and 9 can be written as 3 square. So it is of the form a square minus b square. So it can be taken as a plus b into a minus b. So that's why we have taken 2x plus 3 into 2x minus 3. So it is of the form log of m into n. It can be taken as log m plus log n. So we have taken log m plus log n. Now it is simple form. If the given function is in complex form, first try to make it into simple. Why simple means so that we can differentiate easily, so that we can get some standard formula of differentiation. So we are having d by dx of log x formula, isn't it? So log of some complex form we don't have directly. If it is log x, no problem. If y is equal to log x, then y dash is equal to d by dx of log x, we will write 1 by x, but a log of some complex form. There also, if it is y is equal to tan inverse x, no problem, directly dy by dx is equal to 1 by 1 plus x square. But here it is given that y is equal to tan inverse of some complex form. Whenever it is a complex form, go for substitution, right? That too, particularly in inverse problems, in all inverse problems in differentiation, some inverse is having inside, inverse of, the value is in complex form, right? So then go for substitution and make it in simple form. Try to get that function in a simple form, then you differentiate it. Okay, so practice the problems, be clear with the concepts and be clear with the formulas. In mathematics, these two things are most important, right? You should be clear with the concept, like this. So what is the main thing we have to find, and then we have to do like this. That is called concept, means we have to use this formula, then we have to do like that. Okay, so and formulas are very, very important. If you know the formulas, actually differentiation is nothing but applying the formulas in each and every step. Sometimes we will get one new formula of differentiation. So be perfect with the formulas, then you can easily do all these differentiation, application of derivatives, maxima, minima, so many topics, even the tangent and normal, all these are dependent on your differential formulas. Okay, so that's all for today. Have a nice day.